In today's video, we're going to be talking about taking metformin for polycystic ovarian syndrome, or PCOS, and the pros and the cons. 1 in 10 women worldwide suffer from PCOS, and it is the number one cause of infertility in women. And aside from causing infertility, PCOS can be difficult to live with for many other reasons. It can make it difficult to lose weight, it can cause excess hair growth, and it can also cause acne. So how is PCOS treated? Metformin is a drug that is often prescribed to women with PCOS, and it can certainly be effective at reducing symptoms. But my issue is that women are not informed of the side effects when they are prescribed metformin. So in today's video, I'm going to give you everything you need to know about metformin for PCOS, how it works, the side effects you can expect, and how to reduce them. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high fat, nutrient dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, where I share new posts every single day. So the topic of today is metformin for PCOS. I briefly described what metformin was at the start of this video, but we're gonna go a little bit deeper into what it is and why it works for PCOS. Then we will get into the side effects, and we will finish off talking about what you can do to reduce these side effects and some natural options to metformin that might be better suited for you. What is metformin? Metformin is the number one drug prescribed to people who have issues related to managing blood sugar. This includes prediabetes, gestational diabetes, type 2 diabetes, and of course PCOS. Worldwide, there are over 120 million people who are prescribed it. Metformin helps to keep blood sugar more stable, with less big swings up and down. And it also helps to lower fasting blood sugar. And you might be thinking, okay, well, I have PCOS, I don't have diabetes, so why is metformin effective? And the reason that metformin is so effective for women with PCOS is because the root cause of PCOS is the same as the root cause of prediabetes, gestational diabetes, and type 2 diabetes. And that is insulin resistance. There are three main symptoms that define PCOS: irregular periods, high testosterone, and ovarian cysts. To be diagnosed with PCOS, you have to have 2 out of 3 of these main symptoms. And all three symptoms are caused by insulin resistance. Every month, just before ovulation, there should be a big spike in the hormone estrogen. All estrogen is made from testosterone, but high insulin levels block the ovaries from converting it, and the spike in estrogen doesn't happen. So you do not ovulate, and the eggs remain in the ovaries and become cysts. You are also left with high testosterone levels as a result. Metformin works to improve insulin sensitivity. It allows your cells to take in more glucose, taking it out of your bloodstream and lowering your insulin. And as a result, the symptoms of PCOS improve. But as great as metformin sounds, it does come with side effects. Some of them you can prevent or reduce, but some of them you might be stuck with. Side effects. Now, among the most common side effects of metformin is digestive distress, which includes gas, bloating, and diarrhea. About 25% of people who take metformin experience digestive distress. Metformin interferes with the body's ability to absorb, synthesize, store, and metabolize certain nutrients. This means your body can become depleted in them. 2 of these nutrients are vitamin B9 and vitamin B12. And when the body becomes depleted in these, it can cause digestive distress. Some of the ways to avoid these side effects include starting metformin at a lower dose, taking slow release instead of immediate release, and of course, supplementing vitamin B9 and vitamin B12. Another common side effect of metformin is nausea and vomiting. Again, 25% of people who take metformin experience this side effect. However, taking metformin with food helps to prevent this symptom. Another symptom you might experience is hair loss. Now, this is actually the inverse of one of the common symptoms of PCOS, which is excess hair growth. Women with PCOS can sometimes grow excess hair in places such as their face, and this is because of their high testosterone levels. Metformin can help to lower testosterone, which can reduce this excess hair growth, but it also depletes vitamin B9. Vitamin B9 is responsible for healthy cell growth. So when we become depleted in it, we can start to lose excess hair from our head and also develop bald spots. Now, these side effects are pretty annoying, but they are also pretty mild compared to the ones we are about to talk about. The first more serious side effect is anemia. Anemia is when your blood doesn't have enough healthy red blood cells. In this situation, anemia is caused by very low vitamin B12, and anemia leads to reduced oxygen flow to the body's organs. The consequences of anemia can be severe, so it is really important to make sure you are getting enough vitamin B12 in through your diet. If you're having trouble getting enough in through your diet, I recommend supplementing with something like beef liver. Beef liver is super high in vitamin B12, and it's best to get B12 from whole foods because the synthetic form is not absorbed as well. It is also rich in vitamin B9 as well, which can help with digestive distress and hair loss. But yes, beef liver is gross, I know, it's not everyone's cup of tea, but thankfully there are a lot of great companies out there now who are making beef liver supplements. You still get all the benefits of beef liver without the taste. I will link to some of my favorite brands in the description box down below that are available worldwide or in certain countries, and I do have a few promo codes, so I'll put those down there as well. The second serious side effect is lactic acidosis. This one is very serious, but also very rare. But I also think it's worth mentioning because if you have kidney problems or if you consume a lot of alcohol, you are at a much greater risk. Metformin causes lactic acid to build up in the bloodstream. And if your body cannot clear it properly, that is when lactic acidosis happens. If left untreated, it can result in a coma or death. Natural alternatives. Okay, so now let's talk about natural alternatives. There are two natural supplements that have been shown to work in the same way as metformin, improving the body's insulin sensitivity. In some studies, these have been shown to be just as effective at treating PCOS and different types of diabetes as metformin. And these two supplements are berberine and inositol. Both of these are extracted from whole foods and available over the counter without a prescription. But it is important to note that they also come with side effects. Some people experience a lot of the same digestive distress on berberine and inositol as they do on metformin. I did a whole video a few weeks ago comparing the three, metformin, berberine, and inositol, and going over the pros and the cons and the side effects of each. I will link that video above if you want to know more about that. I am by no means recommending one over the other. I'm simply presenting the facts, and you can discuss with your doctor and come to your own conclusion about which one, if any, is best for you. Now, the other way to treat PCOS naturally does not involve a supplement, because there are ways to improve insulin sensitivity through diet and lifestyle. You can improve your insulin sensitivity by tweaking the foods you eat and the exercises you do. One study followed 11 women with PCOS for 6 months. The study involved a change in diet, and by the end, all women who completed the study lost weight, lowered their free testosterone, and their fasting insulin. Two of the women even got pregnant during the study, despite having previously struggled with infertility. So what diet change did these women make, you might be asking? They switched to a low-carb, ketogenic diet. That was the only change they made. This is effective because it significantly reduces the amount of foods being consumed that increase insulin the most, which are foods rich in carbohydrates. Every time we eat carbs, they are broken down by the body into sugar or glucose. These particles enter the bloodstream and insulin is released to bring the sugar to our cells. Of course, if our cells are resisting the actions of insulin and not taking the sugar from our bloodstream, then our bodies create more insulin in response, and you're left with high insulin levels. The process for digesting protein and fat requires a lot less insulin. Therefore, if you focus your diet around protein and fat, less insulin is needed, and then your cells become more sensitive to insulin again as a result, which in turn improves your PCOS symptoms and can actually lead to a reversal. Now, low-carb diets are not the only approach. I actually have a whole video on PCOS where I give you some more tips and strategies for improving your insulin sensitivity. I will link that video above if you want to check it out afterwards. Even a modest reduction in carbs can be beneficial, or even changing the order in which you eat your food. But yeah, I won't get too much into that today. You can check out that video if you want to know more. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that you found this video helpful. Let me know in the comment section down below what your experience with metformin for PCOS was or is. Did you experience any of the side effects that I spoke about today? Let me know down below, and also remember to give this video a thumbs up and click that subscribe button if you're not already. Also, feel free to share this video on Facebook or with a friend or family member who you think might find it helpful. And if you did enjoy this video, you might also enjoy my video on how to reverse PCOS, which I spoke about earlier. I will link it right here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can find them here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.